of the wind here in this town, the Ardaran. I was very lucky because my antenna system didn't collapse. I was very, very lucky, the Ardaran. Coming back again, the Ardaran. MW6HNN, have you treated over?
Yeah, IV3EPO, MW6H return. Yeah, it's scary, isn't it, George, with all the global warning and all that. And as you say there, you have a tornado there, and you don't suspect it in this part of the world there, in Italy. There was a tornado there a few weeks back there. It was in England, and it only landed in a small area. I can't mind the location in England, but if you were to Google it, on the internet, you would probably find out, and it damaged several vehicles and roofs of houses, gardens, did quite a lot of damage. It was, I wouldn't have liked to have been living in that QTH when the tornado hit there, but for the having it in the UK was, well, unbelievable, and I'd seen it on the social media, and the damage, you would have thought there was some sort of a gas explosion, but obviously it was just Mother Nature, and a tornado was hitting a location in a part in England there, and it was shocking to see what had actually done there. So we are lucky in a way in this part of the world, we don't get bad tornadoes or earthquakes and all that, but it does happen. But I think, as you say, it's all this global warming changing, and there's nothing we can do about it. We can only try and improve it, but I think there's too much damage already done with all the years it's passed there. I know over here in the UK in the next, I think it's by 2030 or 2032, I think they're going to try and do away with all the vehicles and just have electric vehicles over here to try and cut down the pollution there. But it's going to be expensive. I think it'll be a challenge as well, because there's a lot of people that collect old vehicles, the same as we collect radios. But I don't know how that's going to work there. I have diesel vehicles here, and I don't know going down the road of having an electric car coming in my lifetime here anyway, to go to electric from driving a diesel vehicle and having to charge it up. If you're going a long distance, you need to stop several times, over maybe 200-300 miles or so there. But obviously they're probably keep improving them to get further distance, but they're all popping up everywhere now, the electric charging ports around the fuel stations over here in different destinations, so you can charge your vehicle up there. But I don't know, it will end up robots will take over the world. it's a crazy situation, but we need to do something there. I seen it on social media, last night in fact it was, over in Trinidad and Tobago. They had a snowstorm, and it was unbelievable, knowing that there was snow in Trinidad and Tobago at this time of year. It was just one of the storms coming in that Mother Nature threw on them, and it was very unpredictable. But it just shows you how things can happen around the world with all this climate change here. But I'm surprised the propagation has lasted so long at the moment between us there, George. You were peaking up to 5 and 9 there with no issues there. And understandable concern about the storms coming in with the antennas there. It's quite high wind here in the QTH of Tenby here. I live in a coastal area, and I've been quite lucky with the antennas, mind you. We've had up to 75, maybe 85 miles per hour winds during the winter on times, and the antennas have stood up, withheld there. So lucky enough, I haven't had any issue as such, and hopefully the hex beam here will last for many years. India Victor 3 Echo Papa Oscar, Mike Whiskey 6 Hotel, November, over.
Yeah, I'm busy, Darren. With your hex beam, you know that hex beam antenna is very, very light. So I think that you will never have any problem with it, with a strong wind, because it's very, very light. It's not heavy like mine or a cubicle quad or other heavy antenna system like OptiBeam. So I think that you will never have any problem, the Ardaran. Anyway, the electrical vehicles the future, you know, Darren. Also, I got a diesel car for working. And you know that European Commission said that till the production of diesel vehicles will finish at 2030 or 25. I don't remember well. The main problem here, Darren, is that the electrical charging is not very very present all over the country. So if you got an electrical vehicle, you have to find an electrical surge of power, and it's not very easy, the Darren. And you know also that I think that the technology of electrical vehicles is at the beginning. And you know that battery have a very short life, and they are very expensive. I will wait till at least 5 years, 5 to 6 years, because I'm sure that the technology of electrical vehicles will be much better in the future, dear Darren. But this is the main road that we have to follow to preserve our herd, dear Darren. Anyway, thanks again for the enjoyable show. I see many pictures about Tembi on QZ.com, and it's a beautiful, beautiful place in front of the sea. And you have to know, Darren, that I traveled all over the world in many, many places, and I was there in UK three times in my life, but all the times I was in London. And I would like to visit the rest also of the UK, especially Scotland, or maybe or other parts of the UK. But you know that this year and last year there was the great problem. There is the great problem of coronavirus, and so we have to wait for better days, the other. Anyway, you take care, mate. Thanks again for this enjoyable show. I apologize for my bad English. I really hope that you have understood everything I said. I know that I do many mistakes when I'm speaking, but every time when I talk with an English guy or a guy that his mother language is English, it's a great occasion for me to improving it, to improving my bad English step by step. Listen for the final, Darren. Enjoy the rest of weekend time. LW6HNN, IV3PO, send a man clear.
India Victor 3 Echo Papa Oscar NW6HN return is final. Yeah, it's been a pleasure working with you, George, and hopefully we can catch you again on the bands there, and nice to work you on the 17 meter today, and we'll go and have a drink now, and we'll give a few more calls and see who else we can receive here. You stay well, stay safe, and they all noted there it's been a difficult year and a half there, and it's still going on at the moment. Things are starting to open up again, but we'll need to see what happens in the winter now. A lot of people are doing the stay vacations and coming on holiday to around the UK, the UK citizens, but some are still going abroad to Europe, etc. there. But all this virus and everything, it's been a crazy time. I keep saying it's like a movie, a sci-fi movie, but it's not ending. It's been crazy times there. But a good thing out of it, a lot of people have come back onto radio, into the hobby again there with all the lockdowns, and it's great to get some stations coming back to the hobby there. Pleasure working you there, George, and enjoy the weekend, stay well, stay safe, and we'll catch you again when the antennas cross here. India Victor 3 Echo Papa Oscar, Mike Whiskey 6 Hotel, November. Cheers, George, good luck, and congratulations on your radio English, and listening on I'm originally from Scotland, so my English is a little bit different. 73, ciao.
Ciao, Darren. Your English is not very easy to understand for me, but no problem at all. I understood everything you said. You take care, mate. Enjoy the rest of the weekend time. Bye-bye, mate, Darren. Bye-bye.
Ciao, grazie, bye. Should be 17. Yeah, QRV 5 minutes. I'm QRV 5 minutes.